motor cooled down, the heat went down, and that's when I heard that highway sound. Cadillac setting like a ton of lead, 110 a half a mile ahead. Cadillac looking like it's setting still, and I caught Maybelline at the top of the hill. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You done started back doing the thing you used to do.
Broadcasting from Fulton High School for seven decades.
Welcome to the Falcon Nation Information Show. I am Marcellus Jackson. We are here to give you some information about Fulton High School. We will have special guests including the principal, Mr. Smith, and teachers and students. We will also have the school announcements and also inform you on some of our active sports. And now it is time for our Falcon Nation Information Show.
Welcome back to the Falcon Nation Information Show. I'm your host, Lex Cannon, and here with the school announcements is Dre Peebles.
Here are your Fulton High School announcements on the Falcon Information Show. Fulton High School has another hard deadline for turning in work coming up. All makeup work should be completed by Friday, October 23rd. See your teachers for more information. Please make sure that you are charging your Chromebooks at night and that you are keeping up with your chargers. The school does not have extra Chromebook chargers to loan. Please remember to wear your mask at all times in the building. It has to cover both your nose and mouth. If a senior is or will be 18 by November 3rd, they could come to see Ms. Bruce in room 216 to register to vote. This needs to be done before the end of the day. The college of the week is the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga. UTC is a public four-year state university. Here are some interesting facts about UTC. UTC has a miniature indoor water park located in the Aquatics and Recreation Center on campus. UTC has over 150 student organizations available for students. UTC has an apartment-style residence halls located all throughout campus. UTC has a 44-foot tall indoor rock climbing tower. UTC students get into all home athletic games and events for free. Student tickets for Friday night's game against Maryville are on sale now in the main office. Students' tickets are $5. Kickoff is at 7:30. We will be honoring three seniors before the game. You can watch the video stream on the NFHS network and hear the game tonight on WKCS Radio. Teachers, please remember to check the Fulton staff Canvas page for up-to-the-minute school announcements. Any items for the school video announcements needs to be sent to Mr. Mays. Happy World College Radio Day from everyone at Fulton, everyone at Falcon Radio. High school and the college radio stations from around the world are celebrating College Radio Day today. You can get more updates on everything going on at Fulton High School at our website, notschools.org/FultonHS. We are also on Facebook and Twitter at Fulton High School. You are listening to the Falcon Nation Information Show on WKCS Radio. We'll be back in a moment.
When I grow up, I want to be a new pair of blue jeans.
When I grow up, I want to be a kid's first computer.
When I grow up, I want to be a glass countertop in a new home.
When I grow up, I want to be a kid's best birthday present.
When I grow up, I want to be a football stadium.
When I grow up, I want to be a warm fleece on a cold day.
When I grow up, I want to be a fancy backsplash.
I want to be a bike that races around the
country.
When
I grow up, I want to be a bench on a forest trail.
I want to be a rocking chair on
when
a sunny
I grow up,
porch.
I want to be a skyscraper.
I want to be a...
I want to be a...
I want to be a...
I want to be
a... I want to be a...
I want to be a...
I want to be a...
I want to be a...
When I grow up, I don't want to be a piece of garbage. And if you recycle me, I won't be.
Give your garbage another life. Recycle. Learn how at iwanttoberecycled.org. A public service advertisement brought to you by Keep America Beautiful and the Ad Council.
Welcome back to the Falcon Nation Information Show. I'm your host, Lex Cannon, and here is Mac Arthur and PJ Nescog with an interview with Mr. Smith.
Morning, Mr. Smith. How are you doing today?
Hey, I'm doing great. I appreciate you guys having me. I'm excited. It's a Friday at Fulton High School. Hard to beat.
Yes, sir. The first question I really want to ask you is, as a principal, what's the first thing you do to really get your day started?
So for me, I like to get here kind of early, before the building's packed, and just kind of kind of get my to-do list ready and organized, and walk around the school, check on folks, but just kind of the calm before the storm, and get ready, get here early.
That's a good answer.
Thank you.
How are you feeling about today's game? You optimistic we're going to take it to Maryville?
Yeah, I'm very optimistic. Yeah, the football team continues to show improvement. Really proud of their effort and the way they've stuck together and handled some adversity. So we had a week off last week. I'm excited. I think we're ready for the challenge, and looking forward to a little football tonight.
Yes, sir. What really made you want to change the dress code from us having to wear collar shirts every day?
Well, I think part of the dress code changes for this school year kind of came about from discussions we had just starting school in a pandemic, and with COVID-19 concerns, was this a good time to maybe take a step back from the dress code that we've had? A bigger picture, I will tell you, you know, we're going to look this year. I was thinking today we're going to select four or five students from each SLC and really take a look at dress code. I'm more concerned as the principal, everything that we do, how does that impact student achievement and growth? And so we want to take a look at that, from the dress code to our handbook to instructional practices. I think when we look at that, we wanted to give kids some freedom. We still have some security concerns and issues. It's nice, plus it kind of gives, when you have a kind of, each SLC has its own color, a little bit of an identity. But it was a good time to kind of take a step back and look at that.
What were some challenges that you faced getting the school set up and ready due to COVID?
Wow, great question. A lot of concerns. A big shout out to our leadership team. So the leadership team at Fulton High School consists of staff members elected by their peers to be in that role. And we honestly allowed them the freedom, the leeway, and the responsibility to come up with our reopening plan. Worked with the district to make sure we were following protocols and procedures put in place by the district, everything from transportation, food services, security, all those things, and then allowed our teachers to really help us form our plan and what that would look like at Fulton High School. But extremely pleased with the work they did, and extremely pleased with our students thus far, really adhering to all the protocols.
A lot of people in school, they don't like wearing the mask. They feel like they don't need it. But with COVID going around, how do you really feel about the mask situation?
Well, I think right now the masks, are helping us all stay safe. I think my mindset really has been, you know, if I'm asked or required to wear a mask and that allows us to be in school or to have ball games or have extracurricular activities, then I'm going to do that. You know, I think we've probably all seen the campaigns. You know, we wear masks to keep everybody else safe, keep those around us safe, and do our part. So I think there is some personal responsibility in wearing the mask. And again, I would give a huge shout out to everybody, our students at the forefront of that. And sometimes we're asked to do things maybe I don't, you know, all the time agree with in every situation, but it's for the better good of all. So I will do it.
What are some problems that you aim to target at Fulton High School to try and solve?
Okay. I'll probably rephrase that a little bit. You know, I think we have opportunities to help our students, and our opportunities to help our staff, and opportunities to help our community. You know, the mission and the vision at Fulton High School has been really solid since its beginning, and I love it. Enter to learn, go forth to serve. So we're always looking at, how can we be lifelong learners? How can we provide students and staff with opportunities to serve? And again, to go back, you know, our focus as educators is to provide our kids with the highest level of instruction we can. A lot of fancy education talk, but that's tier one instruction. That's standards aligned, on grade level instruction. They give kids opportunities. So we want kids when they leave here, students when they leave here, to be prepared for that next step. It could be a four-year college, a community college. They could walk into the workforce and be ready, be responsible, and be eager. So everything we do needs to be focused on that.
Mr. Smith, with COVID going around, what do you instruct teachers to do to make sure that everybody is social distance in the school?
So that started before students arrived. We kind of had a little extended time to work with teachers to get the building ready. So just physically, it started with a physical setup of their classroom and continued. We asked teachers to make sure that their rooms were socially distanced as best they could do. Knox County's maintenance department has given supplies. The State Department has given cleaning supplies. So there are procedures teachers need to take in order to keep everybody safe, from keeping desks spread apart, wiping down, cleaning things. Our custodial staff has been tremendous, taking on a lot more work and making sure that it's safe for everybody.
Being the principal at Fulton, what was probably one of your favorite things that you've been able to do here while being the principal?
Wow. You know, one thing that really, this is my second year here. One thing that really stuck out last year was when UT Knoxville came and offered, I believe it was 8 students, early admission, just to see the excitement and the kind of the buzz, and to see kids crying and staff members were emotional. That really sticks out, but I'm also going to give you the corny answer. I get to work every day at a place that I love, that I believe in what we're doing. It's truly an honor, and I'm excited to be the principal at Fulton High School. I taught here in the early 2000s and just really always wanted to get back when I left. And so to be back as the principal at Fulton, I look at that as a position of service. And I want to help our teachers grow and support our teachers. And I want to, you know, interact with kids in a way that is positive. I want the culture at Fulton High School to continue to be a positive culture that allows kids opportunities to go and serve.
All right, Mr. Smith, this is your second year being principal. What really made you want to be a principal?
All right, so I taught here in the early 2000s, and I taught at another school prior to that. So kind of getting into the administrative world, you know, the way I view that, you're in a position and you have an opportunity to influence more people. Honestly, you have an opportunity to kind of direct and facilitate growth and achievement at a school-wide level. So I think it was an opportunity to lead. It was an opportunity to grow. I always want to challenge myself. I think that's important for all of us, that we're always eager to embrace the next challenge. It doesn't mean we have to, you know, move all over the place, but we're looking for ways to get better. We're looking for opportunities to serve. We're looking for opportunities to grow. And when the job was offered to me to be the principal at Fulton, I jumped up and down, was excited, and really couldn't kind of pinch myself, but just love it here at Fulton.
If there's any other job in the world that you could have besides a principal, what would it be?
Any job?
Any job.
I'd like to be on the PGA Tour. I'd like to be a professional golfer. Preparing for the Masters that's coming up in November. So now if you saw my golf swing, you probably wouldn't believe I'd want to be a PGA professional, but that'll be my next job.
Mr. Smith, enough about you. I'm going to ask you about Mr. Mays. What's probably your favorite thing about Mr. Mays?
It's got to be his voice, man. The man has a great voice. On a serious note, Coach Mays has just great passion and love for Fulton High School. He's and I mean this as a compliment. He's probably been here since about birth. He's been a part of the fabric of this school.
Yes, sir.
I actually got a letter in the mail this week from a former Fulton. It was either a student or just an alumni community member, and they were listening to the radio station, and they were bragging on Coach Mays and about all the wonderful things that he has done, the opportunities that he gives kids, the confidence that this program instills. And Coach Mays didn't want to toot his own horn. He's not going to stand up and say, look at me. So he's really a kind of a humble servant that wants opportunities for Fulton High School, the Fulton radio station, and the kids in this class. So I am very appreciative of Coach Mays and all his work.
Out of all the classes offered here, if you could take one class, what would it be?
Well, if I could, it'd be the radio. I mean, of course, right here, we're sitting here. I would learn all the ins and outs of radio broadcasting and what that looks like. So I think it's exciting. You know, I love walking down the hallway and hearing the music. Was listening to the radio station on the way into work today. So I think, it provides an opportunity, an experience for kids, for students, that's very rich and meaningful.
Mr. Smith, what is your favorite go-to candy that you like to eat?
I'm not a huge sweets guy, honestly. But if I had to pick a go-to candy, probably some peanut M&Ms. In a pinch, I'll go with some peanut M&Ms.
I have to ask, what were you like in high school? Like, did you play any sports or do any extracurricular activities?
I did. I did play a little football and baseball mostly. And as a student, I was okay. I probably didn't push myself the way I needed to be pushed. I think part of that kind of sets the stage for what I want to do now. I was able to kind of, I don't want to say coast, but I didn't push myself and apply myself the way I needed to. So that kind of drives me today to, push kids and have them excel. I enjoyed high school. I really did. I had a great experience, had some great friends. You know, I went to high school back in the Stone Age compared to you guys. It was different. But, you know, I think today all the tools and the resources we have today, I wish we would have had them back when I was in school.
Mr. Smith, I play football, and me and a lot of people have been arguing about what the toughest position is to play on the football field. What do you think that would be?
Toughest position. I mean, I will say this. I would say playing quarterback in the NFL may be the toughest position in all of sports.
I agree.
Everything you have to process and know, and you have to know everybody's position. So I would probably say quarterback, just because, again, you have to know what everybody on the team is doing and relaying the plays into the huddle and communicating that. And there's a clock that's running. You got to beat the clock, and you got to make decisions in a second. But I love football. I think football is a wonderful team sport. You know, 10 out of 11 guys can do their job, and if one guy doesn't do his job, the play's not going to work. So it requires the ultimate kind of team sacrifice and purpose. And I'll go on a little football journey with you. And football's tough, I'll tell you. Don't tell Coach Black, you know, football practice back when I played, it wasn't a whole lot of fun. I mean, it's really, really hard. To go out there and kind of sacrifice your body. I appreciate what all of our kids are involved in extracurricular activities do. It's extra time. But I do love football and looking forward to tonight's game.
All right, that's about all the time we have for this interview. So we're going to cut it here. I'm going to give it back to you, Xander. Thank you for having us.
Thank you, guys. Go Falcons.
All right, we'll be back again shortly.
Dad, this is fun. I didn't think I'd like kayaking.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it, but I think it's time to head back in.
Okay. Can we come back?
Sure. Hey, be careful getting out of the boat.
It's a kayak, Dad.
I'm going to return the kayak.
Can we walk home?
How about a
taxi?
It's a short fare from your neighborhood to your naturehood. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a neighborhood park or green space near you. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the U.S. Forest Service.
Everybody buckle up.
Bum, 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 bum.
Buckle up.
Let's go.
Buckle up.
Can we go to the store?
Come on, buckle
can we get
up.
Some ice cream?
Everybody, buckle up.
A lot goes on in the car, but you're in control. So only move when you hear the click that says they're buckled in. Never give up until they buckle up. Learn more at safercar.gov/kidsbuckleup. A message from the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
When I grow up,
I want to be a new pair of blue jeans.
When I grow up, I want to be a kid's first computer.
I want to be a warm place on a cold day.
I
want to
be a football stadium.
I
want to
be a bike that races around the country.
I want to be a bench on a forest trail.
When I grow up, I don't want to be a piece of garbage. And if you recycle me, I won't be.
Give your garbage another life. Recycle. Learn how at iwanttoberecycled.org. Brought to you by Keep America Beautiful and the Ad Council.
In 95, I helped tow your trailer. And in 09, it was sparks from me, your chains, dragging behind your truck that accidentally started a wildfire.
Spark a change, not a wildfire. Visit SmokeyBear.com, brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council.
Mike Rowe on the skills gap and how a student organization known as Skills USA is trying to fill it.
So the thing about Skills USA that's so cool, and the reason that my foundation has supported it for years, is that it's deliberately and intentionally focused on celebrating a skill. 3 million jobs right now exist in the trades and transportation and commerce. The skills gap is real. Training kids and getting them excited to do the jobs that exist ought to be job one. Skills USA does that in a big way. It's about excellence and competition and being good at what you do, and eventually through all of that, learning who you are. Skills USA is working.
Skills USA, champions at work.
Learn more at microworks.com and skillsusa.org.
We're back again with the Falcon Nation Information Show. I'm Lex Hannon, and here's Mariah Hobby and Winslow Borovich with Student Life Segment.
The vision and the mission. What a quote from our principal. What the heck? That is like actually a cool quote.
Did he say that?
Yeah. Yeah, he did. He said that like mid-interview.
Oh. What did he say what it means?
No.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but honestly, our principal, I wasn't expecting him to be that energetic today.
Yeah. I mean, well, he's like that every day.
He is?
Yeah.
I don't know. I rarely see him.
He's a very happy man.
That's great.
I mean, yeah. Yeah.
Mm.
I think it's a good way to makes us happy. But
how's your day, Mariah?
It's going. We're good. We're going good. I mean, I'm glad it's Friday.
Oh yeah, definitely. You know, I get to record up top on the press box. Sorry to flex this every like 5 minutes,
yeah,
but
right.
I get to record on top of the. Up top on the press box, that I get to record the game.
Are you up there all alone?
No, I'm pretty sure I have someone up there with me. Who was up there with me last time, Mr. Mays?
Scott Weisgarber is his name. He films for the football team.
Okay.
So you do.
Yeah, it was
someone.
Really cool.
Yeah.
I remember. I think it was some. He was calling. His wife was calling him the whole time. It was funny. I'm pretty sure it was something about like. Maybe his car or something broke down, but his wife kept on calling him, and like, and something happened where she was like giving out snacks to coaches. Like, I had no idea where the story was going. I was listening the whole time. I forgot about the camera.
So you're an eavesdropper?
Yes.
Okay.
So you are recording the game. Xander, you play for the band, right? And
yeah.
How is being in the band? That's my question.
It's interesting during this year because normally we're up in the stands with the rest of the fans, but this year we're in the end zone, so we get hit by footballs occasionally.
Yeah.
But other than that, it's pretty fun.
Yeah, you guys, I remember my past couple years. Obviously, I've only been here for 3 years, but you two, the band always plays like a lot, or at least I've always realized you guys play a lot during the game, but this year you guys don't seem to be playing as much. Maybe that's just because of the football team. I don't know how football works, but...
We're playing a whole heck of a lot. It's probably just harder to hear us because we're down there.
Last game, you guys definitely played a lot compared to the last time. But, yeah. Good job for you guys, though.
Thank you.
Winslow, you have a lot of fun recording up there, right?
No. No, I'm kidding. Yeah, I do. Yeah, I have a lot of fun, honestly. At the end, like... My legs were hurting a lot, though, because I had to stand up for, like, 4 hours, and I'm overweight. So...
No.
Huh?
No.
What do you mean, no?
No.
Look, I'll...
Don't do that.
What do you mean? Okay. What were you looking at before, Walter?
Oh my god.
Hey there, Walter.
Can you not do that again?
Can you? All right. So I've done it twice, but I photographed the football game, and it's probably one of the most. I know nothing about football, so keeping up with that ball, and trying to get it in like a nice picture.
No.
I can't do it for the life of me. If my life depended on it, I wouldn't be here. That's all I have to say.
I remember seeing you up top on the press box because of your haircut. Because you're the only like girl there with like
pretty
short
long hair.
Yeah, pretty long hair.
Long hair.
And some pretty short hair.
Long.
Short.
Long.
Short.
So worry about me. So we do have fall break coming up. Do you guys have any plans for fall break?
I don't really have anything like planned. No.
No plans, Winslow.
No, I'm planning on just sitting around playing video games all day, so.
Does your birthday come, it comes after fall break, right?
Yeah, October 27th.
Mm-hmm. And do you have any plans for your birthday?
No.
No.
Just
okay.
Some cookie cake. That's
cake?
Yeah.
You
yeah,
any,
I
like,
love cookie cake.
Presents in mind? Anything
yeah,
you want?
Well, no, not presents. I usually just get money.
Okay, well, do you buy anything with your money?
Yeah, I'm thinking about buying the Xbox Series S. And then having my little brother Holden buy the PS5. And then, I was thinking about, and then I'll pay for the game since he wouldn't have any money left.
Right.
And the PS5
effort.
Will be fully his, the Xbox Series S will be fully mine, but we can play on each other's consoles whenever.
Loving the cooperation. Loving it. Very good. And you, Xander, do you have any plans with your girlfriend, Jennifer?
Not really. No, not over fall break. I did lose 35 pounds in the past 2 months.
Oh, that's
so
great.
We're going up to Gatlinburg to celebrate that next weekend, I think. So that'll be fun.
What are you going to do in Gatlinburg?
The current plan is go to this place that sells really good beef jerky, because I've not had it in a long time. And then we're also going to go to that, what's it called? Something similar to Joe's Crab Shack, just for fun.
Yeah, I think I have a shirt from there. there's a place, Gatlinburg, Pigeon Forge. They're different, right?
Yes.
Okay.
They're close, but they're different.
There's a place in Pigeon Forge I really like to go to. That it there used to be one down here in Fountain City called Rita's Italian Ice. They have really good, like, Italian ice. That's it. That's all I have to say. I'll probably go back up there during fall break. And you still don't have any plans for fall break. I'm going to ask that again, but you don't.
I guess that should be my plan, to go to some fancy restaurant.
It's like ice cream.
Ice
fancy
cream?
Or a restaurant.
It's not even really ice cream, it's like
Italian ice.
Yeah.
Italian ice. Yeah, the only like, I had some like good chocolate ice cream yesterday. You know, it was like chocolate on chocolate on chocolate.
Was it from the store?
Yeah.
I think I might know what you're talking about.
It was like...
Was it expensive?
It's something like... I have no idea.
It
had something to do with, like, you'll die from chocolate. It was weird. It was weird.
Sounds expensive.
Like, it had, like... it does. But it had, like, something on the front, like, some quote saying, like, you'll die from how much chocolate is in this.
Did you die?
That was kind of... No.
No?
It was kind of scary, though.
Are
kind of like
sure?
A warning.
You sure you didn't die?
Hmm?
Okay. Sounds like it was good ice cream.
Okay. Well, I think that's just about all about the time we have. I think we'll play some PSAs and see you guys later.
We'll see you soon with sports.
In 95, I helped tow your trailer. And in 09, it was sparks from me, your chains, dragging behind your truck that accidentally started a wildfire.
Spark a change, not a wildfire. Visit SmokeyBear.com, brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council.
Mike Rowe on the skills gap and how a student organization known as Skills USA is trying to fill it.
So the thing about Skills USA that's so cool, and the reason that my foundation has supported it for years, is that it's deliberately and intentionally focused on celebrating a skill. 3 million jobs right now exist in the trades and transportation and commerce. The skills gap is real. Training kids and getting them excited to do the jobs that exist ought to be job one. SkillsUSA does that in a big way. It's about excellence and competition and being good at what you do, and eventually through all of that, learning who you are. SkillsUSA is working.
Learn more at microworks.com and skillsusa.org.
Welcome back to the Falcon Nation Information Show. Here's Marcellus Jackson and Tommy Sweat with school sports.
Hi, I am Marcellus Jackson here with Tommy Sweat. We're going to be telling you about Fulton Athletics. Our ladies' Fulton soccer team plays Sweetwater October 6th at home at 5:30. Make sure to come out and support their last regular season home game, and it will be at Samson Park Complex. The final game will be against Carter at 6:30, and it will be away October 8th. And it will be, yeah, at Carter, my bad. But, so yeah, we'll move on to Fulton High School Volleyball. The tournament starts Tuesday, and it will be at Carter because they said that Fulton couldn't meet the requirement. So yeah, it will be at Carter. And make sure to come out and support our girls volleyball team, because they need our support.
Right, they do. You know, it's sorry, we're getting the mic adjusted, but yeah, sorry. Going back to soccer, you mentioned it's at Sansom. They played Loudon last night. They had a tough little game against Loudon. I think that they are still winless on the season, but that's okay. Talking with the superstar Abby Diggs, Sweetwater is a beatable opponent, so that could be. It's not. It was supposed to be their senior night, I believe. But it's a winnable game. You said that's Tuesday? Monday or Tuesday?
Yeah, it's Tuesday.
Tuesday over at Sansom. So, really, that could really be a big game for the Lady Falcons. You mentioned volleyball. Do not know anything about their record just because they don't. High school sports, volleyball, it's not really kept up with a whole lot, and as far as I know. But, like you said, it's at Carter. And, I mean, they can make a run. You never know. Me and Jackson, we always talked about in the postseason, it just matters who's gonna show up and play. So, maybe the Lady Falcons volleyball team, you know, they're ready to play come Tuesday over at Carter. So, yeah.
About football, I feel like we're ready.
I feel like we're ready, too. You know, big game tonight. Kickoff at 7:30 against the defending 6A champs in the Maryville Rebels. But I think we're ready, too. I think we've had a good week of practice. I mean, it hadn't been perfect, but it's been sloppy at times, but I feel like we know the mistakes that we made in practice, and I feel like we're ready to correct them on the field against a really, really good opponent. And I think we've been talking. I mean, I was out last week. Luckily, it was our bye week, but watching film on them, they really are beatable. But you can't go in with that mindset of, oh, we're gonna blow them out. Oh, we're gonna do this, because they are Maryville.
Yeah, they're good.
And we're gonna have to play mistake-free football. They're probably gonna have to make a couple of mistakes. We gotta capitalize on them. But, I mean, if we worry about that, it's probably not going to be good. But if we worry about ourselves playing mistake-free football, I think, like you said, we're ready. And yeah, we could really shock the world, as we were talking about yesterday.
Shock the world. But, yeah, Maryville is a good team. Like, they've won 17 state championships.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, they also, I mean.
Yeah, they won it last year. Yeah. And we played them last year, and I think, what was it, 49-19. We had, like, a couple of special teams touchdowns. I think we had a defensive touchdown. But they really just had their way with us. I think they lost about 30 seniors, though. But everybody that knows Maryville knows that they just bring new kids in out from the barn somewhere. They just corn feed them, and then they wait for their senior year, and then they bring them out. So they're going to be ready, but I think we're going to be ready, too. And it's going to be a really good game.
It is. And more about Maryville, like, their team, they have 40 playoff appearances.
That's, like,
that's
good bit.
Outrageous, for real.
Yeah, I wonder what their streak is. You know, ours is 11. Do we get that in the info? I'm sure it's like 20. When you say it's about 20 playoff appearances? Yeah, 20 plus. But, George Quarles, I think he left in 2016. Derek Hunt, the coach right now, he took over in 2017. He actually won a state title in his first year. His second year, they got beat by Oakland, who's always a perennial powerhouse in Middle Tennessee. And then they won it last year. So two out of his 3 years, he's a state champion coach. And, yeah, like I said, they're going to have players just like they do every year. But it's going to be a really good game. So come – what time are they opening the ticket booth? I believe it was 6:30? Yeah, so five. Yeah. Six. Yeah, so 6 o'clock, the ticket booth behind the stadium. Don't forget to come out. Tickets are $8. $5 if you're a student, I believe, but I believe you can only buy those in school. But $8 a ticket. Ticket booth will open behind the stadium at 6 o'clock. Don't forget to come out and support your Falcons tonight in a big non-region matchup, but should be a really good game.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I believe that's all we have. Is that it?
I mean, yeah, that's it.
There we go. Send us home.
All right, and that's been today's Falcon Nation Information Show. We'll see you next week.
This has been Falcon Nation Information. Make sure to tune in next week for our next episode of Falcon Nation Information here on 91.1 WKCS Falcon Radio. Lit.